How you doing? My name is Julius Cephas, and I'm glad to be sitting in for Herman Holloway, Jr. And I'd like to thank Herman for letting me sit in tonight for a half an hour. But tonight we have a great guest. We have the Deputy Director of Parks and Rec, Shawn Allen, who I like to consider a good friend. I feel like he's up and coming. And I want him to explain what is the city doing, what is the Williams administration is doing, what's his vision for Parks and Rec. Also, because I worked for 7 years with Parks and Rec at Stubbs School. Also, I was a Golden Glove boxer at West Center City. We have like 8 Golden Glove champs. So Parks and Rec has been a big deal in my life growing up, and it kept me out of a lot of trouble. And I think it's a great program, and I would like Shawn to come in and explain what some of the things that what he's doing and what the Williams administration is doing. And again, how you doing, Shawn
Allen? How you doing, man?
All right.
Thank you for having me. First of all, I just want to say thank you for giving me the opportunity to come on here, part of the Williams administration, and just explain what we're doing down Parks and Rec. I actually came in, I was appointed by the mayor in January 2013 of this year as the deputy director of Parks and Recreation. As you know, Romaine Alexander was the director, Claude McCray is now the director, and I took over as deputy director. And Janet Lane, who was the prior deputy director, prior to me getting there, if I was to say anything, we're basically there. Our vision is to basically enhance the activities that we already have, that Parks and Recs already have, but just to try to come in and move from more of a social services perspective. Coming in, having hands-on, going into the homes, mainly focusing more on education, going into the homes and having a more hands-on approach with most of the young people. Because I believe coming from a neighborhood, you know, with a lot of challenges growing up myself, and not having a lot of people around to basically look up as the leaders, because I come from a family where growing up, I didn't have a father. My father got shot and killed when I was 5 years old. So coming from, you know, that standpoint, I know how it is to be in a community without a leader, without an individual to turn to. So Parks and Rec is just trying to be that vehicle to go inside the community, like I said before, to have a more hands-on approach of working with our young people, providing more activities, not just activities, but this year, we are not just putting our rec sites with bouncing basketball, playing games, but this year our rec sites are going to be equipped with life skill programs.
Okay. Again, John Sheehy, Mr. Bowman, I mean, these are serious shoes to fill. So, and I'm hearing what you're saying. What are you doing? So tell me some of the things that life skills are, what are you doing? I know I've heard you talk about your, your trauma center, but just go into some of the things that you're doing now and where y'all, the direction you're going now and what you're trying to get to.
Well, it's starting with this summer. We had, because of the budget cut, we were able to still hire over 14 young people in the summer employment program. I think what was different this year, because we set a criteria where kids...
You said 14, or what's the total number?
The total number was 389.
There you go. Okay.
It was 389 kids that we hired this year. We used a new criteria this year. Basically, a lot of kids were being hired, and a lot of times we didn't know if they were even in school or not.
Okay.
So we asked the kids to bring a report card. We asked them to, kids that had a 2.5 point grade average, they went to the top of the list. We asked if they could get a letter from their community centers or from a faith-based organization. That gave them a little bit more seniority on the list. And one of the things we try to put these criteria in place because of the fact that that gave us a basic idea, you know, what type of challenges that our young people were facing, were they going to community centers, were they involved in any faith-based institution. Basically didn't put it like, say, if they weren't there, they didn't get the job, but it gave us a better opportunity to find out where young people was. And this year was good because 70% of the kids that we hired this year got hired for the first time.
Oh, that's
we had kids that been actually applying, trying to apply for summer jobs and actually didn't get hired for the last 3 years, but they applied. But 70% of our kids that applied this year were first time kids that ever were employed by the city of Wilmington for summer youth. And moving this moving into that, we're just trying to basically, my staff has just got trained on gang and gun violence and the stages of change. We're talks about what they were taught and trained on pre-contemplation and contemplation. What that does is enable us the opportunity to be able to identify the youth that we're working with. When a youth is in pre-contemplation, that's a youth that's just not listening, don't want to hear nothing. A youth that's in contemplation, it gives us the understanding after we're training them and giving them leadership skills that they're beginning to listen, they're beginning to change the old ways. And I think on a holistic level, young people need to change their old ways and find a new way of thinking.
Okay. Now, and I like I said again, I'm a product of Parks and Recreation. I'm a product of recreation. Talk about your trauma center, because the trauma, I think you were taking some kids to Philadelphia. Explain that to the viewing audience. What that mean and what's going on?
Okay, the trauma situation started about 5 years ago before I came to the city of Wilmington. I had my own nonprofit called the YES Program, Youth Empowered to Strive and Succeed. Through my process of networking, I met a man named Scott Childs. He worked in, he's from Los Angeles, but he worked in Temple University Hospital. I began to take kids up to a program called Cradle to the Grave, which is in Philadelphia, Temple University Hospital. And Cradle to the Grave is about an individual, Lamont Adams, who was, who was shot 18 times altogether with 24 exit wounds. He was 16. Unfortunately, Lamont Adams didn't live. But what this trauma program does is actually walks you through. They take you from the beginning to the end. They have this thing in Philadelphia where if the police arrive on the scene and the ambulance is not there, the police have the right to pick up the individual. It's called scoop and swing. They throw him in the back of the police car. Lamont Williams was thrown in the back of the police car. He arrived at Temple University Hospital. He was brought in. And what they do is, once you walk in there, they put a young person actually in the trauma center on the gurney, and they take Lamont Adams' actual medical report with these red dots, and they place him on the body of the young person. It's real dramatic, and it's a real emotional process because the way that they do it is live. And in reality, the whole time this process is going on, they show how they had to take a chest cracker, which is this instrument where they slit you open on the side, and it's a chest cracker where they put it down in you and they begin to turn. It starts to crack your chest. And they use that at times where they begin to massage your heart and try to save you. But the whole important thing, a lot of young people, when they see this, because a lot of young people get shot around here, and some that fortunately live, they really don't tell the person what they really went through. And in that process, you being slit open and them trying to save your life would take sometimes about 11 to 15 minutes. You get no anesthesia. Everything is just basically done trying to save your life. So in that process, young people get the opportunity to see up close and personal what gunshot wounds really does to your body. And I took over 2,000 kids up there. This might not be believable, but out of the 2,000 kids, only of them 2,000 kids, one kid unfortunately lost his life since I've been taking young people up there. I'm really excited about.
Now, let me ask you a question, okay. Have you talked to the parents after these kids went through this program? Have you talked to any of the parents?
Yeah, I've talked to a lot.
What are some of the responses that you get from the parents?
The responses that I get from the parents is that the kid is, they want to stay away from guns. Okay. They never knew it was like that. I think the parents are real, after they hear the experience that their child went through, that they're real excited that their child had the opportunity. Because I think it's about intervention is good, but if you can prevent something before it happens, I think that is the best thing. I think one of the most important things from parents, their parents' feedback, and what they say about the program is so exciting. A lady named Kay Boris, she's the outreach coordinator out to Christiana Care. We've been in talks of actually bringing that program down here to the city of Wilmington. So we will hopefully within the next year, we're working on it now, the next year we will have the first gunshot wound prevention program here in the city of Wilmington.
Okay, well, one thing I can say, we need this program, but also, and what I want the viewing audience to understand, you have a lot of politicians come to you, ask for your vote. As soon as they get your vote, the first thing they do is cut these programs in the city. You have to hold them accountable. We need more money for summer youth programs. We need more things for our children. And again, we have to hold accountability. We vote very well, but after we vote, we leave them alone. We must make them be accountable for our vote and what we need. And these are good programs. We're gonna go to a commercial, Shawn, and I'm gonna ask you some more questions about Hicks Anderson Center, which I feel though that helped me out a lot. I'd like to go to a commercial and we'll come right back with about Hicks Anderson Center. All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jay Caldwell speaking, and I'm here to invite you to the big anniversary celebration of the Gospel Ambassador, Sunday, November the 3rd, at the East Island Fair Baptist Church, 1400 B Street. Our pastor is Dr. Christopher T. Curry. The doors will open at 5 p.m. sharp, program 6 p.m. sharp, and we're going to have a hallelujah good time. Our guests this year include Little Sam and the Flying Clouds from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the Southern Gospel Singer from Washington, D.C., Carol and the New Anointed Stephen Singers from Jersey City, New Jersey, Brother Kenny Davis and the Dynamic Melody Airs from Baltimore, Maryland, the fantastic Soul and Air from New York City, and last but not least, Evangelist Sister Serena Ford. Our MCs this year are Brother George Witcher and Sister Marva Richardson of Channel 28 TV. Advanced donation $20 at the door, 22. Seniors and children, $18 at the door only. For more information, call 654-7062, 658-0278, 762-3249, or 656-0700. Meet us at the Ezine Fair Baptist Church, 1400 B Street. God bless you.
Okay, we're back again. We're talking to Deputy Director Shawn Allen, and again, like I said, Parks and Rec has been very good to me, very good to a lot of people in the city and county. Okay, Hicks Anderson Center. Again, one of the things that saved my life, we had a great boxing team. We did very well. What's going on with Hicks Anderson Center?
Well, we just, about 30 days ago, as you probably know, and the public probably know, that Hicks Anderson has been without a director since February 2013. Ed Johnson, who was the activities coordinator there, was as the acting director there up until 30 days ago. The city of Wilmington just hired a new executive director. Her name is Dr. Tonya Conley. Over Hicks Anderson Center, she's been there about 30 days, so she's just probably just making her way in. But Hicks Anderson Center, basically over there, we still have boxing, we still have swimming, we still have the game room, arts and craft. But I spent about 3 days over Hicks Anderson Center, and a lot of times I've heard a lot of stories about a lot of people coming out of Hicks Anderson Center, how Ed Johnson, how Mr. Hicks used to have a lot of people in there mentoring. There's a lot of people that was mentored that come out of Hicks that are doing real good things. And now I think our vision now is how can we begin to take a lot of the young men that come through Hicks Anderson Center and make them change agents to be mentors for these young men that are coming, not just young men, these young ladies that are coming in, and get a lot of adult ladies, make them mentors and change agents to be able to come in and mentor these children so they can be successful the same way people like you that talked about, you came out of Hicks, be successful.
And what about programs? Do y'all have tutoring? I know when I go over there, sometimes I see some computers, I see different things.
We had a computer room, we had app school program, we had tutorings on Thursdays from 4 to 7, and we just started the Wilmington Leadership Commission back up, which is under this is a mayoral initiative under Mayor Dennis B. Williams, and we have a real diverse group of kids. We got kids from LACCs. The Wilmington Leadership Commission, the ordinance prescribes us to go to each community center here in the city of Wilmington and ask for 3 of their leadership type youth. And as of now, we have 15 youth. Some of them coming from LACC, Kingswood, Hilltop, the Powell Center, and it's steady growing. And it's prescribed for them to have a 2.5 grade point average, be involved in extracurricular activities. Last week we introduced them to City Council. The City Council Committee, Youth and Families Committee. This week, this Thursday at 6 o'clock, we will be introducing the whole Wilmington Youth Leadership Commission to the whole City Council and to the public. I'm asking everybody to come out. And one most important thing is this Tuesday from 5 to 7, we'll be having an open house, and the mayor will be there speaking. We're inviting everybody to come out.
Where's the open house?
501 North Madison Street. That's William Hicks Anderson Center, 501 North Madison Street, from 5 to 7, and that's the open house, and that's introducing our new executive director we have there, Dr. Conley.
Well, one thing I like that you're doing is that, you know, most of us like sports and different things, and you're tying education to that, and that's giving people the motivation. If they want to continue this activity, they must keep their grades up, which is a good thing. Tell me some more about some of the other things in the city that y'all doing.
Other than the stuff that we do in the community center, we got the maintenance department in there, and we're trying to keep the parks clean, keep the park safe. I think one of the things that we're doing that's most important in the Williams administration that we're trying to do, that the mayor has stressed to us, that we just not make Parks and Rec about basketball, about physical activities. I think that now we're doing flag football. We'll be having rec sites coming up. Then we'll be having basketball come up. We'll be having the Crozier League coming up. We'll be having tennis in the streets coming up. We got a lot of activities, but we do not just want to have activities. This year, we'll have young people. You must be involved in some type of life skills program, because I think a lot of times you can come to a facility and play basketball, you can box, you can do whatever, but after you go home, if you don't have no life skills, you don't have no coping skills, you can't make the proper decision to get away from violence, then you're in trouble.
Right. What about, and I've been watching, and a lot of other countries do this, meditation for the children. They teach them early in Japan and a lot of other countries. Meditation, yoga, different things. Is that something y'all might want to consider? Because again, every time I've gotten in trouble, it's been when I react. But when I had a chance to sit back and think about it, I'm okay. And I know a lot of other countries, they teach that. And that's something that might be, that y'all might want to, I think the younger you teach the kids how to meditate and do so certain skills, they're less likely to get in trouble. Because I know, again, I've always got in trouble when I react. But if I don't react and I get a chance to take a 10 count and relax a little bit, I'm okay. What about something like that?
We're open for anything. I know me, if I was to speak personally for me, I think my main vision when I came there is that come to Parks and Recreation, I just want to help somebody. If If I can't do nothing else, I just want to help somebody, because I just know how it feels to have idle time and have nothing in your life, nothing structured. And I just want to be able to take a young person and have every part of their day, if I can, structure. Because I believe if you have every day of your life structured with something positive, then it leaves no room for you to do nothing negative.
Now, what about for, again, people who might want to volunteer to teach, to tutor, read, and do different things? How could they get in touch with you or Hicks Anderson Center? Who could they reach if they wanted to be involved on a volunteer base?
Well, if you wanted to volunteer for the city of Wilmington for anything, you can contact the Wilmington Sanderson Center and ask for Dr. Conley at 571-4266, or you can give me a call at 576-3812. I'm always open for somebody who just wants to come in and help another young person just get to that next level, because that's what I think it's about. It's about helping a young person get into that next level, and all the help that we get, it kind of enables us to make our job a little bit easier for us to open up other avenues to help more young people. So anybody that wants to volunteer and wants to be a part of this mission of us helping young people to be productive, I'm open for it. Parks and Rec's open for it. And I know that the Wilmington administration is open for it.
And I believe too, especially for some of the seniors, a lot of young people need to have their experience and have their wisdom fed to them. And I think if any seniors want to volunteer, because again, y'all have all the knowledge. All the knowledge is with the seniors. And again, contact the mayor's office, contact Hicks Anderson Center, Dr. What's her name again?
Dr. Conley.
Dr. Conley. Again, and Shawn, I want you to start coming on, letting people know what the city's doing. Mm-hmm. Let them know, because again, we hear so much negative, but I already know the positive things that you're doing. And I would like to see you bring it to the people and let them know what's going on.
Oh, no problem.
You know, and I'm going to give you a minute, half to close, and then I'm going to say something, and thanking Herman Holloway for letting us come on. But I would like you to go ahead and say something in closing.
Again, I just want to say that if anybody would want to come out and volunteer, again, over Hicks Anderson Center, 302-571-4266. Or you can get in contact with me at 302-576-3812. And never hesitate to give us a call, because we're always open for new ideas, new initiatives, and for with anybody that wants to help young people be productive and just get to the next level. I know you've probably seen a lot of things out in the public, but it's about really just helping a young person or just helping somebody. I came to Parks and Rec to help somebody, because somebody helped me, and that's the reason why I'm sitting in this chair.
Okay. Again, I'd like to thank Herman Holloway for allowing me to have sitting in for him. I really appreciate it, and Herman is a strong leader in our community. Also, I will. My nephew's having a play, Mrs. Independent, October the 19th and October the 20th, Saturday and Sunday at the DuPont Theater. I'd like y'all to attend this play. But again, I would like to say just say thank you, and Shawn, I definitely. I just say, keep up the good work, man. Mm-hmm. Keep up the good work. And the Wilms administration, y'all need to come out, let people know the good things that y'all are doing. And I'd like to say good night to everybody. And we'll see you soon. Thank you.
Billboard campaign in the city of Wilmington promoting a confidential telephone number 888-1800 to help stop the violence in Wilmington sincerely needs your help. This anonymous call will not show your name or telephone number, so be a part of it all. Make the call to report any information that may solve a violent crime or prevent one. Remember, we are all in this together. Help our residents feel safe again in their homes and in their communities. Help to get the illegal guns off our city streets. Innocent people are getting shot and killed. Who will be next? Make the call. 888-1800. Sponsored by the Kingcenter. Billboard campaign in the city of Wilmington promoting a confidential telephone number 888-1800 to help stop the violence in Wilmington sincerely needs your help. This anonymous call will not show your name or telephone number, so be a part of it all. Make the call to report any information that may solve a violent crime or prevent one. Remember, we are all in this together. Help our residents feel safe again in their homes and in their communities. Help to get the illegal guns off our city streets. Innocent people are getting shot and killed. Who will be next? Make the call. 888-1800. Sponsored by the Kingcenter.
Good evening, everyone. I am Linwood Jackson. Herman Holloway is taking a much